There's different ways to detect plagiarism. The way that I detect plagiarism is I simply read students' work. When you write, you have your own voice. And it's very obvious to people who read a lot when a voice changes. We can tell when it's your voice and when it's someone else's voice, and then it's back to your voice again, and then another voice. It's important that you write the paper and that you not use other people's work. But when you do bounce between voices, we usually can notice. And the next step is to just type it into Google and see what we come up with.
Typically, as professors, as a semester or a quarter goes on, we become very familiar with your writing style. You use certain types of sentences. You use a certain vocabulary. Everyone has a different style. Everyone has a different presence in their writing. And a lot of times when people are new at writing, they're unaware that they themselves have a style. But your professors are pretty sophisticated as far as reading goes, and they can identify style. So if you end up writing three or four papers, and then for your final research paper, you turn something in that is radically different, the typical grammar errors that we're watching for you as an individual aren't present anymore. The vocabulary that you've been using all semester is not present anymore. The certain MLA or APA errors that we've been seeing aren't present anymore. It sort of raises a red flag. We understand that there's going to be improvement throughout the semester, but when the entire style changes, it just feels like someone else did this. This raises a red flag, and it makes us end up snooping and trying to find if it was, in fact, plagiarized. Some professors use a service called Turnitin.com, where you upload your paper to this service, and it sort of scans and makes sure that this paper doesn't exist elsewhere. But it's pretty easy to catch plagiarism even without online resources like that. You can always sort of find a tell that a student left, that this isn't their original work.
We've been looking at a student writing all semester, and suddenly they're writing like a person who's published a magazine article, because that's actually what we're reading. Or they're writing like a person who was published in a book or a scholarly journal. That's what we're reading. We're not reading the student work, and we know we're not reading the student work. So that kind of deliberate plagiarism, that's a big problem. But students will also plagiarize sometimes because they just didn't give themselves enough time to do the assignment. They didn't start out wanting to be dishonest, but they're panicking. It's the night before something's due, and it's a lot easier to find things on the web and try to change things a little bit here and there so it won't be noticeable. However, it is noticeable. So whether it's deliberate dishonesty or panic, or maybe not understanding that you have to indicate every piece of quoted material and you have to give sources for everything that you use, these different varieties of plagiarism are all, they all have one thing in common. They can cause a failing grade, and they're easily recognizable by instructors.
It's pretty easy to detect plagiarism, and we look for it a lot more than I think a lot of students assume we do.